Okay, I am back to answer your questions on another episode of Ask Abhinav. We've been doing so well. This hashtag now has over 1.3 million views. Can you believe that? Well, you better believe it because it's real. So today what I want to do, I have a little bit of time and have a lot of questions to get through. So I thought what better way to do that by getting on this and answering them all back to back. Jarell asks, hey, I'm 15. I started smoking weed when I was 12 and now I just kind of turned into a shitty person. I don't know what to do. I felt disconnected from reality for months. So Jarell, you already know the solution. The solution is you need to come back to ground, earth, okay? You've been floating for too long. You've lost touch. Maybe you're disassociated with life. And the only way to get that back is to actually put yourself back in the real life situation and stop avoiding the responsibilities that are ahead of you. That means you're gonna have to put the weed away for some time and you're gonna have to focus on picking up the responsibilities that you've put away and blown off by just smoking every single day. It's the hard truth, but it's the reality that's gonna work for you. It's gonna be tough for a couple weeks. That's why the Discord community is a great place for you to get support as you need it. But just know there is a better future for you if you choose to go down this road. So you decide, you're in control. How can I stop smoking weed and get away from friends that do? Well, if they are truly your friends and you tell them, hey guys, I'm not smoking weed for the next month because I've decided I'm gonna change myself. If they're truly your friends, some of them might even come on board and be like, you know what? I think that's a great idea, Justin. I'm gonna go and do that with you. And let's see what we feel at the end of this month and how we can be better. And if they're shitty friends, they'll be like, no, that's stupid. Don't do that, this and the other thing. Then you know that those people don't have your best interest in mind and they're gonna eventually bring you down to their shit level, because they are not your true friends. So get rid of them. There's 8 billion people in the world. You can find more friends. I promise you that. Put yourself around the people that you want to be like, and that's how you will make newer friends. Start implementing those things that you want out of life within yourself, the 5 pillars: exercise, nutrition, hydration, sleep, meditation. Focus on those 5 and join the Discord group. All right, so Dylan asks, I'm trying to stop smoking because my grades have fallen greatly. My family life is bad, and that is all me and what my friends do. What should I do? I don't want to lose my friends. Dylan, they're not your friends if they're bringing you down in life. These are just people that you've put around you. There are more people you will meet. Look for quality, not quantity of friendship. Find people that you want to be like, whose life looks good to you and something that you think you can model after. Don't look for people that are convenient and do the same stupid shit that you are no longer interested in doing, like smoking weed every single day. Okay, Travis asks, yo, I smoke a lot of weed and I surround myself with a lot of people that do. And I really have an open mind to quitting, but everyone around me is just so successful that it doesn't even matter if they do or don't. That's how I see it at the end of the day. What's your advice? So Travis, if you think that because you're surrounded by people who you think are successful and they smoke weed and you think you can get the same results and you're not, then clearly you don't have the same work ethic as those people. So maybe it's time for you to cut back on the weed and put it away and spend more time on developing a harder work ethic and sticking to the things that you know you should be doing and actually completing them. And maybe using it as a reward system instead. So that's what would be my advice. People like to compare themselves to other people. You're looking at where someone else is today, not where you were yesterday. You can only walk forward from where you are, not where someone else is. So there's no point in comparing to what they're doing and how that's working for them, because there's no guarantee that that's gonna work for you. And clearly, if you're sending me this message and telling me that you aren't successful and other people are, dude, make the change. Find out, there's only one way. Get after it. All right, so Eric Pate asks, hey, I saw your TikTok video about realizing it's time to stop smoking weed. So I've stopped about after 10 years of constant smoking, and I've surrounded myself with people who don't smoke. But now I crave a bowl regularly, and it's hard not to call those people and fall into old habits. What's something I can do to curb those cravings without turning to the other vices? Thanks for your time. So Eric, first and foremost, congratulations on figuring out that this wasn't the right path for you, and then you've taken some time off. I'm sure you're gonna feel significantly better. So the 5 pillars that I always talk about, sleep, meditation, hydration, nutrition, and exercise, should be your focus. And while you do those things, you will find newer friends at the gym, at the park, at a sports club. You will find new people that are into the same things that you are. there's an interesting thing in life about vibrations. When you start to vibrate at a higher frequency, you only start to attract people at that level, not below. So there's no reason for you to go back to the same losers that were smoking weed and doing nothing with their life, because you've already changed and become better. So I would recommend you join the Discord group and find some new friends that are similar to you. I've seen your TikToks, and I'm 22 years old, and I've been struggling to find myself as a person to just love me for me. I've been struggling to find real happiness, and I want to change my life. I smoke weed now just because I'm used to doing it every day and my regular routine, and I want to change my diet, the way I eat, the way I think, and the way I feel in general. Ronnie, first and foremost, I want to say this is the first step. Now that you've realized that this is a problem, you can actually take action towards it. You can actually now make a plan to get better from it, focusing on the five pillars. Some of them you're already mentioning: diet, hydration, exercise, meditation, getting good sleep. Bro, five things that will change your life, no doubt about that. And no, you don't need weed every single day. It actually diminishes its effect if you do it every day. Just like, you know, your tolerance goes up, your effects go down. You have to keep doing more and more just to feel something. What a horrible way to live. So absolutely think you should do it. And I want to encourage you to join the Discord community. It will help you have motivation, have other people that are on the same path, and you will get better. Just make sure you stick to daily goals. Small steps, big actions. Let's get it. Ooh, fired up. All right, so Spencer asks, hey man, I'm 15. I started smoking around 11. Good God, so early. I can't remember anything anymore. I need some help. So Spencer, you're probably realizing that you've done some damage to your memory. And that's very sad because you're so young. So you have more life ahead of you than what you've lived. So my advice to you is to completely cut this habit out, at least for the time being. I'm not saying you have to quit forever, but there's no way you can get through another few years of your life and complete school successfully, or even get a job at this rate you're going at, where your memory is complete shit. I would recommend starting to implement a daily meditation practice, start journaling, start writing things down, because your memory is bad. That will help you to remember more things and keep track of the things that you are forgetting. Okay, PJ asks, yo, I was really trying to stop smoking, but I was good for about a week, but I really just could not sleep. Any suggestions for that at all? Absolutely, I have suggestions for sleep. Put your phone away before you go to bed, because if you're scrolling on TikTok or Instagram right before bed, you're already setting yourself up for tossing and turning and thinking way too much in your head. I don't know if you've noticed this. When your phone turns off, you're still thinking about the things you saw on the internet, okay? So make sure that you don't set yourself up for that disaster before bed. You need to put yourself in a calm state, turn on a guided meditation, some chill music, read a book, yes, a physical book, not an ebook, get some pages in front of you, start writing down things, plan the next day, write down the thoughts in your mind, how you're feeling, if you're feeling anxious or whatever have you. Those are all great alternatives to make sure that you're prepped for bed. Now, I don't recommend you going from weed to melatonin, but for a short period of time, maybe a week or so, if it helps you, go for it. Zinc and magnesium are also other supplements you might want to look into a little bit, but make sure you talk to your doctor about this. So Quinn asks, hey, I smoke almost every single day and I'm trying to quit, but after a few days, I always just end up smoking again. Do you have any tips? So if you know that you're weak-minded and you are going to cave every single time because you've tried to quit before, the best thing for you to do is to get rid of all of your stash. Give it away to someone, throw it in the trash, just get it the hell out of your sight so you don't get tempted. And you need to give yourself a month, 2 months of sobriety to see if you can actually make changes in your life that are gonna make you feel better again. That's the best thing for you right now in your situation. You can't have it around you because you don't have that self-control. You need to give yourself time to build that self-control. Make sure you join the Discord community. We will support you and make sure that you get through this. Hello, I'm trying to stop smoking weed, but how can I stop? But I can't stop. I'm trying to smoke weed, but I can't stop. Well, first and foremost, Mark, that's a mindset. The fact that you're telling yourself you can't stop is just going to make it harder for you to stop. You need to believe and really know that you can do it. So you need to say a different, you need to create a different dialogue in your mind. Start telling yourself, I know I can be healthy and I am taking steps towards that every single day. And then start actually taking steps towards it every single day by cutting down your consumption in half, going down to only consuming once a day, and then tapering to every other day. That's how you get yourself a leg up on yourself, your mindset, and then your actions. Get after it. Carver asks, hey man, I've been smoking almost every day for about 7 months, and right now I'm on a tolerance break. When I start again, I don't want to smoke every day. How can I smoke weed but not let it control my life? Please. All right, Craver, it's very easy. You need to make sure that you have an intention behind getting high. If you're gonna do it just because you're bored, then you're gonna put yourself up in that same position where you're smoking every single day without any purpose. So I would recommend only using it on a weekend, or only using it one day of the week, or once every 2 weeks, so that way you still have enough time in between to go without it and continue to build that self-control with it. And when you do it with an intention in mind. Like, I'm doing this because I've had a great 2 weeks. I've worked very hard on my health, on eating right, on getting enough water, on meditating and exercising, and I want to give myself a little break to rest and recover and just chill. And that's when you can maybe use it as a reward. But if you do it for any other reason, like just to do it and just to be bored, it's gonna again go back to those compulsive habits that you have formed. All right, so thank you so much for asking your question. I hope this helps you. Make sure you join the Discord community. Make sure you ask more questions. Send this video to a friend if you know that they can get help from this. Thank you so much. This is The Real Abhinav. You've just been watching the Ask Abhinav Show. See you guys next time.